Tesla, widely known for developing self-driving consumer cars, introduced the most powerful supercomputer. This isn't really a surprise for the company, as Tesla CEO Elon Musk has tweeted about Dojo since 2019 in building the fastest computing chip. In this video, the Modern Day Geeks are going to talk about why Dojo Supercomputer is different. For starters, supercomputers are not really similar to general-purpose computers. They are high-performance scientific instruments that have been used primarily for scientific and engineering work requiring exceedingly high-speed computations. To achieve Project Dojo's goal of creating the best AI training performance that can learn and process more complex groups of data without sacrificing power/cost efficiency, they built this tiny chip that could process so much more data than a consumer GPU, graphics processing unit, and CPU, central processing unit. They thought about how to build this, so they came up with an idea of distributed computing architecture. The Dojo is operating at a tile level. The single tile is 9 petaflops, and the tiles are going to be connected to one another. Venkatara Menon, the engineer himself, says the chip is like GPU-level compute with a CPU-level flexibility and twice the network chip-level I/O bandwidth. This is backed by the fact that the Dojo supercomputer can have the capacity of an exaflop, which is 1 quintillion 10 to the power of 18 floating-point operations per second, or flops. For reference, the world's most powerful consumer GPU, the NVIDIA Titan V, can handle only 110 teraflops, or 110 trillion flops, 10 to the power of 12. While the world's most powerful consumer CPU, AMD Ryzen Threadripper 3990X, only has 13,209.6 gigaflops, or billion flops. The GPU on your laptop could only have around 3 teraflops. Don't be fooled by the size of this chip, though. These are built without any gaps, which means that everything you see on its surface can handle data. Thus, multiple chips can be connected to each other to form a more powerful processing unit. Currently, the world's fastest supercomputer is Japan's FUGAKU supercomputer, which can handle 442 petaflops or 442 quadrillion flops, 10 to the power of 15. This is primarily used for pharmaceutical purposes, such as studying the chemicals that will work well for certain diseases and analyzing massive amounts of simulations. In second place, we have IBM's Summit supercomputer, with only 148 petaflops. Thus, Tesla's Dojo supercomputer would soon be crowned as the world's fastest supercomputer. They really don't aim to be the most powerful supercomputer per se, but to be the best supercomputer when it comes to artificial intelligence technology. So, if more powerful generic computers are built in the future, it doesn't really matter, since Tesla's main purpose is AI learning. The Dojo supercomputer has several uses in various industries, but this idea started because of the self-driving system of Tesla. Although people are impressed by their vehicles, Tesla still believed that the system of their self-driving cars could do much better. With over a million vehicles that send out massive amounts of video data, the company needs a more powerful supercomputer that could process, learn, and train the neural nets in order to improve the self-driving experience. Neural nets, by definition, are a form of computing system that has interconnected groups of data. In similar terms, it's like the neurons of the human brain. Supercomputers are used for simulations, creating and calculating endless possibilities of certain situations at a greater speed than a normal human brain can usually handle. Tesla created their own chip internally, which means there are no other companies involved in the process. This is because they used to team up with NVIDIA in order to create a supercomputer. However, it wasn't enough, because GPU chips aren't really designed for artificial intelligence AI learning systems. Thus, they built their own supercomputer, called Project Dojo. Did you like the video? Don't forget to like and subscribe for more Modern Day Geek content.